Hi, I'm Jeff Klein, editor of Radiographics, and we're here today to discuss the paper entitled Multi-Detector CT Imaging of Surgically Proven Blunt Bowel and Mesenteric Injury, which appears in the current March-April issue of the journal. Today, we're pleased to have with us two of the authors of this paper, Dr. David Bates and Dr. Christina Libetis, who are here to discuss their group's paper with our readers. Welcome, Dr. Bates and Dr. Libetis.
Thank you.
Christina, we'll begin with you. Yeah. Your paper reviews the multi-detector CT findings of bowel and mesenteric injury in patients who sustain blunt trauma. It's my understanding that there are institutional differences regarding the CT scanning protocol for the evaluation of blunt abdominal pelvic trauma, and that at Boston University Medical Center, you have a dedicated abdominal trauma CT protocol that you use. Can you describe the multi-detector CT protocol that you employ at BU for the evaluation of these patients?
Sure. So with respect to trauma imaging, there's no standard protocol like you had mentioned. There are two commonly employed techniques, one being the segmental approach, which we use, and a whole body CTA. With the segmental CT approach, we first obtain an unenhanced CT scan of the brain and cervical spine. If a CT thorax is warranted, we do a CTA of the chest from the thoracic inlet through the spleen. This is followed by a portal venous phase contrast CT of the abdomen and pelvis from the superior aspect of the diaphragm through the greater trochanters. So we employ the segmental approach. We do include the CTA through the solid organs in the upper abdomen, specifically for the tip of the spleen, because it can be helpful in identifying early arterial injuries.
Christina, thank you. David, your paper reviews the mechanism of blunt bowel and mesenteric injury in patients and then discusses the management of patients who sustain these injuries. Can you briefly review with us how these injuries typically occur and discuss how the surgeons evaluate and manage affected patients?
Sure, absolutely. The three types of blunt bowel injury or mesenteric injury that have been described are shear injury, crush injury, and burst. The shear injury is basically occurs when you have a rapid deceleration, and parts of the bowel that are vulnerable are areas that are fixed. So you can imagine the ligament of Treitz, the ileocecal valve, or the sigmoid colon. When you have that rapid deceleration, it can cause a shearing force resulting in injury. A crush injury is the other second type, which is when you have bowel that is typically compressed against the axial skeleton. So whether that's from a seatbelt in a motor vehicle accident or against the dashboard, you could imagine the duodenum against the vertebral column. Is one way. And then the third is a burst injury where you have increased intraluminal pressure that just causes a burst of the bowel. And that can occur when you have bowel that's sort of predisposed, like someone with an ileus or pre-existing bowel obstruction, Crohn's disease. And those typically result in perforation along the anti-mesenteric border of the bowel.
David, thank you. Christina, let's move on to discuss some of the findings that we should be aware of when we're interpreting these multi-detector CT studies on these patients. Your paper breaks these down into direct and indirect findings, and then it details the associated injuries that are commonly seen in affected patients who have blunt bowel and mesenteric injury. We'll begin by looking at figure one, which demonstrates a very uncommon but very specific finding of bowel injury, and then we'll look at figure three, which details the detection of free air in affected patients.
Okay. So as you mentioned, the direct findings for blunt bowel and mesenteric injury include both discontinuous bowel enhancement as well as free air. Figure one highlights the discontinuous bowel wall. On the first part of this image, A, you'll see that there is jejunal wall thickening, slightly more superior to this level in image B. You see oral contrast extravasating through a focal defect in the jejunum. Although we do not commonly administer oral contrast in CT for trauma, it is used to troubleshoot problematic bowel loops, which we suspect a bowel wall injury in. The second image, three, highlights the free air that we touched upon. So free air is a specific but not sensitive finding for bowel injury. In this image, we see a 14-year-old male who had sustained blunt abdominal trauma with the handlebars of his bicycle. And there are two small foci of free air adjacent to the duodenum, as well as retroperitoneal fluid. These findings were highly suspicious. The patient was brought to surgery, and these findings were confirmed as duodenal perforation at these sites. The location of free air is something that I'd like to highlight. It can be telling as to which portion of the bowel is injured. Retroperitoneal air would classically be associated with injuries to the second through fourth portion of the duodenum, ascending and descending colon. The remainder of the bowel is intraperitoneal, so that can be helpful to distinguish which loop of bowel might be affected.
Great, thank you. So David, regarding the indirect findings of blunt bowel and mesenteric injury on multi-detector CT, can you discuss your approach to those patients with possible mesenteric injury, which I know can be problematic?
Yeah.
What should we be looking for in the mesentery in these patients? And I think as we discuss this, we can refer to figure 11, which I think illustrates nicely some of the mesenteric findings that we see.
Sure. Broadly speaking, before we hone in on the images for this figure, there are sort of two things you can look for. Mesenteric infiltration is one where you just have a hazy appearance with some increased attenuation in the mesentery. And that can be seen with just a mesenteric hematoma with or without a bowel injury associated. And then the other thing that you can see is a mesenteric extravasation, which is a little more specific. And we'll probably push the surgeon to operate sooner than later. If you take a look at the figure, this is a patient who, on figure A, has a small focus of extravasation along the mesentery adjacent to the sigmoid colon, and also has hyperdense fluid in the pelvis. And then if you look at the coronal reformat of the initial scan, there's really quite a lot of extravasation that's in that left lateral position, lateral to the sigmoid colon. And so this is a pretty significant shear injury. It's a typical location where you have that fixed point of the mesentery. And for this one, they actually brought the patient back. We review the trauma scans in real time, so I guess they just went in and put in rectal contrast to see if the bowel wall was intact and showed that it was. So this is really an isolated avulsion of the mesenteric root of the sigmoid colon, which was confirmed at surgery.
Interesting. Well, that's very interesting. So, Christina, one last question for you, if I may. Regarding the findings that are associated with blunt bowel and mesenteric injury, can you review the issue of chance fractures and how these are related to bowel and mesenteric injuries? And I think as we discuss this, we'll pull up figure 13, which is, I think, a nice example of this particular association.
Yes. So chance fractures, although they were described a long time ago, 1948, there has been literature showing that blunt abdominal injury, specifically bowel injury, can occur in this setting. So patients who sustain chance fractures do have an association with bowel injury. In a publication out of the University of Maryland, they demonstrated that 40% of their 53 patients with chance-type vertebral fractures indeed had bowel injuries. And they noted that the bowel injury was particularly likely when the fracture pattern had a burst component to it. At our institution, we have several of these patients, one highlighted in figure 13. This is a 25-year-old woman who had a chance fracture, so hyperflexion injury of the lumbar spine with distraction of the posterior elements. And at CT, we noticed that she has mucosal hyperenhancement and bowel wall edema in several loops of bowel. due to the association, the high risk for her having an underlying bowel injury, she was brought to exploratory laparotomy, and indeed devascularized ischemic bowel was encountered, which necessitated a right hemicolectomy and partial small bowel resection.
Well, excellent. Well, thank you for that. And just in closing, Dr. Bates, Dr. Labettis, I want to thank you for taking the time today to review some of the details of your paper, which again can be found in the current March-April 2017 issue of Radiographics. Thanks very much.
Thank you.